Alright, we out. Scariest thing ever, man. I hate riding, and I didn't have my my license on me. I rode all the way from the Bronx back to Queens just to get it. I left it at my sister's house. Not a good look when you're watching out for the cops every 2 seconds. And it's mad traffic out there and shit. About to get some food with my friend Jen. That's my homie. We getting them hibachi dates. Because all we like to do is eat. Just want to get into my place now. I finally got it in Bridgeport. Set up my electricity, set up my cable. So I'm just kind of playing the waiting game until July 1st to get into my apartment. I'm very antsy. I'm tired of sleeping on my mom's bed or Shauna's air mattress. It's just, I want to get in my place. They keep saying, hey, you'll be in your place in a week or so, 2 weeks. It's only been 2 weeks. It's not that deep, but they ain't never had to depend on somebody and sleeping on somebody else's space. You know what I mean? Like, I haven't been not on my own since I was 18. I'm 27 now, so it's like, yeah. And that time to be on somebody else's couch and shit. It's not me. So. But that time is coming, so we'll be there soon. Excited. So yeah, super scooter guy. The public, people's just out in the open. It's like, oh, how much is that scooter? They like the scooter. See, it's like superpowered, so they're like, yeah, that shit is kind of hot. I just tell them, hey, about 5,500. Get you a nice Kymco Xciting 500RI ABS version. You know, it does what I needed to do. I've actually passed its 600 mile service, so I kind of need to take a light for this last ride before I get my service tomorrow out in Brooklyn. So, people ain't focusing as shit. Leffert Boulevard. Yeah, whenever the Van Wick is just royally packed, I pretty much just take Leffert straight up. And then, see what happens. That dude just don't give a fuck. He's a backup to everybody. These cars are interesting pieces of work. They feel like they're gonna accelerate faster than a bike will. Although this bike isn't really that abnormally fast, but fun. Them bitch. Orange is the New Black. That's my shit. Lights starting to get annoying as fuck. Looking good. Hey, and that purple. Turn that white. Oh my goodness. Wow. Jesus Christ. Take it down, boy. woman is a beautiful thigh.
some energy to ride a bike, mate.
Another dude out there getting his ride on and shit. All these people, one person cagers. That's what I call. Well, I mean, I'm a one person cager too, I guess. But like, the idea is that I am I'm being a little bit more efficient in my ride. You know. You know. Yeah, boy. Stone Bridge, the raggediest bridge in New York City. They have been doing construction on this bridge for pretty much all my life. I mean, I don't know when they have not been doing construction on this bridge. Saying, riding up this thing, getting whiplash and shit. But yeah, no. Hey, gotta do what I gotta do. Alright, so Whitestone Bridge connects Whitestone, Queens with the Bronx. Letting you avoid Manhattan. Or at least the busy part of Queens. It was built after the Triborough Bridge, but before that bridge over there, the Throgs Neck, which was built to alleviate some of the traffic on this bridge. You ready to take it down, boy? You ready to take it down, boy? Looks like they're building a little golf course and shit over there. Should be cool. You ready to take it down, boy? Yes, people, I'm riding a fucking scooter. This is what a scooter can do, baby. Shit. I just don't feel like shifting gears. But I'm still out. Nothing wrong with that. Be recognizing how a scooter can get down. So, all you people out there want to get on two wheels, you know what I'm saying, kind of want to get started, you know, maybe you don't want to deal with the shifting aspect of it yet, just want to get acclimated to the two wheel concept, you know what I'm saying, get you a little scooter, you know what I mean, get you a little 50, get you a little 125, I'd rather probably 125, at least you can go on the main streets. But you know what, I'm being real with you, I started on this 500 because I felt like I kind of wanted to be able to go at higher speeds, to be able to get on the highway. Why spend money on a bike and then I'm gonna want to sell the shit and get a new bike? So I felt like I was gonna be taking my MS off course. I figured right after my MS off course, I want the bike that I want. And the crazy thing, I actually bought it before I actually took the MSF. Well, no, I'm lying. I took the MSF, failed the first one because they gave me a fucking motorcycle when I wanted a damn scooter. And, you know, again, that gearing shit fucked me up at the beginning because, you know, I was stalling a little bit. They're not, you know, docking you on that necessarily, but, like, it kind of takes you out mentally a little bit. So, for me, it was like, that kind of brought me down a little bit. Then I started messing up on other parts of the damn test. And then I actually fell off the bike, so I was like, this ain't going to work. You know, but I decided, you know, fuck that. I'm gonna get this shit. I want to ride. I want to do it. I'm gonna do this shit. So I actually got, you know, at that point I already had my permit. So I got my bike and I said, fuck it. I'm gonna just do a little, you know, local, try to go around the block, you know, practice in the parking lot a little bit. Just get on two wheels before my second MSF course. I'd be slightly comfortable. You know, I only had my bike a month before my second MSF course. But I passed it, and again, I had a scooter on that one, and it was only a 125, which is interesting because I was already practicing on a 500 at that point. So, now forget it, my Yamaha Zuma, that's what I passed my test on. So, I can fuck with Yamaha too, because without Yamaha, my ass would not have my M license. So, thank you, Zuma. But at the end of the day, you know what I'm saying, I'm hyped. Had my 500 already, didn't pass the MSF course, then I was ready to be out. Instead of kind of playing with a little bitty machine toy and then being kind of mad because I wanted to upgrade a little bit. So, you know, I didn't get the biggest. I could have got that Bergman's 650. That shit was more money. I wasn't feeling that. And to be honest, like this Kymco Xciting was just like the perfect price point, the most bang for your buck type of situation. So, you know, I'm excited about it. I like it. I love the bike. It's a little tall, but, you know, I make it work. Just gotta give them a heads up. Cats is coming. They don't be knowing this shit. So, but yeah, you know. So, you know, I'm hyped I got this bike. You know, this is my longest trip right now. I've never done a trip this long, but you know, I'm gonna have to get it together because in about a week I'm intending to ride this all the way up to Bridgeport, Connecticut, where my new apartment will be. So I want to make sure I feel relatively comfortable doing that. So this is a very good test of that proposition. So, you know, I just came from Queens, went over the bridge, you know what I'm saying, through the Bronx. Now I'm about to enter Westchester County. You know, it's a sizable ride, so, you know, gives me a good idea of kind of what I'll be dealing with, you know, and if I need to take time when I do that longer ride, you know what I'm saying, I will stop at every rest stop, if necessary, before I get that bitch up to Bridgeport, Connecticut. But it's getting up there, that's going to be my ride, and, you know, it's nice commuting on this bitch, it's nice parking, you know, right up to the spot where you want to be at, you know what I mean? Shit. My friend had a party on West 43rd Street. 500 West 43rd Street. Ain't nobody was parking over there. My little bike just cruised on up in there. And we was in there. So, you know, that's how we get down. So, yeah, boy. Yeah, boy. Yeah, boy. So now we out about Mernon and shit. Now I do try to keep a little distance about with the, oh, he's talking about that motherfucker. Not with that, you know, all on people ass and shit. I don't like motherfuckers on my ass either. Wanna switch lanes? Switch lanes, motherfucker. That's what we on this day. That he bad for it. He was talking about his brother, and that's how he sounds. I'm like, oh, fuck off. I don't know. I didn't think riding would be this exhilarating, but it really is. Like, it's, you're connected to the road, you're out there and shit. You're a little bit more focused too, I must admit. You know, you see what the fuck going on. You know. And to a degree, I think it kind of makes me a better driver, too, because I'm looking out for things a little bit more. So, right now, it's a win-win, you know. It wouldn't be cool if I end up in an accident. I'm not feeling that shit, but, like, Rama Najee. Najee Rama. Rama Najee. Najee Rama. Rama Najee. Najee Rama and Rama Najee. That's my man Martin. Yeah. Mm-hmm.